Enjoy the best IPTV free services Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Service for any device from any location at affordable prices.
Tell me how to stop loving you. Never stop. Tell me how to take away your thoughts from my head, and I will stop. Tell me how to erase every memory we had, and I will stop loving you. I can't stop on my own.
How do you stop loving someone?
Hi, I'm Michaela. It's crazy when two paths cross and then you become strangers again, but with memories. Sometimes it feels like you're the only one that loved and the other one didn't. But I don't think that's really true. I just think some people don't really understand the value of love. I've always heard the saying, there's a million fish in the sea. But what do you do when only one fish really sticks out to you? I've always been one that's difficult to love, but easily I can give it. Sometimes things happen that we have no explanation for, but we have to trust the process and the path that we are going down. One piece of advice that I've learned is learn to love yourself the way you would love somebody else. Nothing beautiful grows without water. So let these rainy days be the days that you grow into something breathtaking.
This is a very common question. I'm sorry you're going through it. What you're going through is called a trauma bond. You have to think of it like an alcoholic or a drug addict. They know it's bad, they know it's toxic, they know their family hates it, but they can't stop. The reason you can't stop is because the very nature of the narcissist is to take their insecurity, their hatred, their misery, their lack of love, and put it on you, called projection. So during your relationship, every time they said, you're cheating on me, when they were actually cheating, you proved to them that you wouldn't cheat. Well, as you proved it, your subconscious was listening that you will never cheat. You proved them when they said, you don't love me. You kept proving to them that you love them. Well, every time you did that, your brain is made of electrical neurons. The neurons built a neural pathway, very much like there's a pathway on this side that says, 2 + 2 = 4, it's an automatic response. You built a highway pathway in your brain that says, you love this person. No matter what, I still love you. I'll never cheat on you. Of course, I'll do that for you. Every time you had to forgive them for something you knew you shouldn't forgive them for, the pathway was strengthened and your subconscious kept listening. Accept forgiveness or forgive them, even though you know they're not sorry, because you love them, because you love them, because you love them. And that pathway keeps getting built. Kind of like every time you're thirsty, drink alcohol, drink alcohol, drink alcohol. You're thirsty for water, and somehow you've trained your brain to reach for alcohol. You're craving affection, and somehow you've trained your brain to think about this person as the answer for affection. The answer is not simple. You have to go through withdrawal. Withdrawal of anything, including dopamine, is very painful and very lonely and very sad. Look at anybody who's gone through withdrawal. I'm so sorry we are going through this. You, me, 200,000 followers. But the answer is exactly like alcohol. You must not contact them, see them, think about them. You have to immerse yourself into something else, some hobby you had before, some new hobby you never had before, something that gives you pleasure, and you're so busy doing it that you have no time to think about them. And pretty soon you'll be addicted or to the dopamine that thing gives you, the gym, the library, the TV, something healthy, taking care of yourself. It's not easy. It's time to roll up your sleeves and get something done that's healthy for you. We're here to help. Welcome to the club.
How do you stop loving someone?
I'm sorry.
When you don't want to love someone anymore because it hurts too much. How do you stop?
You don't.
So I've been having a lot of people reach out to me and ask me the question, how do you stop loving someone that you love with your whole heart and your whole soul? And the only response that I can possibly give somebody is that you can't really stop loving that person. When you love somebody in this capacity, you can't just flip a switch and stop caring about them and stop loving them, but you can develop mechanisms to help cope in better ways and shift that love for them. You don't need to stop loving them to get over them. You just understand that it is a different type of love that it will transform into. So when you try and force yourself to stop loving somebody and you try and come up with reasons to not love them, you end up resenting them, which actually pulls you farther away from the healing that needs to happen. If you're having a hard time, maybe you're not supposed to stop loving them, but just shift that love.
If you've been in a toxic relationship, it can be very hard to stop loving that toxic person. So if you're experiencing this, I'm gonna give you some tips to help you. First, you wanna remind yourself about all the bad things they said and all the bad things they've done and how much hurt that they've caused you. And remember that they said and did those things deliberately. They had a choice and they chose to treat you that way. Then you have to remember all of the chances you gave them to change, which they only used to blame you and hurt you more. You also have to keep in mind that they lie about love and almost everything else. It's a hard pill to swallow, but they never loved you the way that you loved them. Then you have to ask yourself, would you even want to spend time with this person just as a friend? Now ask yourself, would you be with this person if you knew you could be with someone else that truly loves you and cherishes you? You have to compare and contrast what value they have brought into your life and what you have brought into theirs. Next is to repeat all of those steps as much as you need. And if this is too hard for you to do on your own, get the professional support that you need. And remember, you are worth it. Don't forget that.
I've gotten an insane amount of comments and questions and messages saying how to stop loving someone. And in my opinion, that shouldn't be your goal. Your goal should just be able to move past this and accept it and learn the lessons. But if you do want to stop loving them, you have to feel the emotions as they come. Stop trying to control your emotions and avoid them and control what happens. Just appreciate the journey. And I know that sounds hard, but that's really all that you can do. It's like when you're told you can't do something, you want it a million times more. So just stop thinking about it, experience it, go through the way.
How to fall out of love? If you for some reason need to fall out of love from somebody, the brain works like this, that whatever you focus on, it believes it's super important and it tries to refocus on all the time. Therefore, falling out of love means cut associations, don't look at photos, don't listen to music, don't smell their t-shirts or hoodies. Remove all associations to that particular person, and every single time your brain wants to think about it, break that pattern and think about something absolutely different. That will help your brain move the thoughts to something else and you will fall out of love. If you want to do this even faster, you can write one list every single day about the 10 bad things they did. You can even make them up. Your brain will believe anything you put into it if you now have to fall out of love. That was one short tip from me. Follow me for more tips.
How do you stop loving someone? Well, this may come as a surprise to you, but when you actually loved someone, you never stop loving them. You just eventually find someone that you love more.
If you're someone who catches feelings easily, this video is for you. This is how you stop catching feelings for everything with a pause, or even just like chill it out a little bit. It's obviously easier said than done, but with a little practice and just like making this your lifestyle, it will help a lot. You're not special. Okay, that sounds harsh, but hear me out. When you think someone's nice to you, they treat you well, you're like, oh my God, they treat me so good. I'm so different. Well, they're treating other people like that too. You think that's their game. That's how they get people, is by being nice, by treating them good, doing whatever. So stop thinking you're special. And realize they do this to everyone, and that'll help you. Stop creeping their socials and don't fucking lie to me. I know you're fucking creeping that shit.
Three tips on how to let go of someone you love. So number one, cut contact. Before you do anything and anything else, as much as it hurts, you need to cut contact with that person. Have in mind that you'll never be able to heal if you keep the person that hurt you close at hand. This is your sign to remove that person's phone number, social media, contact information, or pictures that connect you right to them. My love, you're not removing your memories. You're removing your ability to potentially contact that person whenever you feel like you're in a vulnerable moment to reach out to them. Number two, practice forgiveness. It may have not been your fault, but it's your responsibility to fix that mainframe and wound. That way, whenever you get into your next relationship with somebody else, you won't carry that burden or baggage on that person. And number three, take all the time you need. In this healing process, allow yourself to fully experience the loss, because truth of the matter is, there are no quick fixes.
How do you fall out of love with someone? Well, your brain works like this. The more you think of someone, the more important your brain will think that that person is. So you want to stop thinking about the person. And you do that by getting your brain a lot of new things to think about. Try new activities, meet lots of new people. Because the more new things your brain needs to focus on, the less it can focus on the old person, and you will fall out of love soon enough.
You want to know the difference between a boy and a girl when it comes to love? See, a boy can make you believe that he loves you when he doesn't. But a girl, she can make you believe that she doesn't love you when she does.
I don't love you anymore.
Since when?
Now. Just now. I don't want to lie. I can't tell the truth, so it's over.
Doesn't matter. I love you. None of it matters.
Too late. I don't love you anymore. Goodbye.
How do I stop loving her? You don't, my brother. Don't ever stop loving her. Learn to forgive her. You're confusing love with hurt. You want to know how to stop hurting because of her. Love is only a word unless an action is involved. Forgiveness is the ultimate action of love. Forgiveness is delivered by a man and not a boy. If you can love her enough to forgive her, you become a man that can love himself. See, I forgave my ex for her part in the marriage and owned my part as a poor leader. I got rid of the blame inside of myself from disappointed expectations, and that kept me from falling into bitterness. The most important thing was I took the shame of my loss and turned it into positive courage and pursued my purpose. I realized that the love I was giving her, I could give to people like you and me in need that's hurting and mentally fatigued to the point of suicide. See, love takes the hurt out of everything. Learn the value of loving your enemy and you'll learn the value of love. Step out of the bullshit, baby. Believe that.
Ooh, here's how to stop falling in love with the idea of someone. The first step is to catch yourself when doing it, which is surprisingly hard. 2, realize you literally don't know this person. They are a stranger. Remind yourself of that. 3, realize you're falling in love with the idea of someone and that the person that they are will never live up to the fantasy you've built in your head. 4, do not conflate and extrapolate the person that they are to how you assume they will treat you if this person is your partner in a relationship. 5, focus on how they've treated you so far. So don't be like, ooh, this person volunteers and they care about the environment, so that means they'll treat me amazingly in a relationship. Like, no. This person could be a saint to their family and friends, but if they haven't healed past relationship stuff, the way they are as a partner for you in a romantic relationship will still be shit.
3 ways to stop love bombing. If they're rushing the relationship or coming on too strong, voice that you're uncomfortable with how fast it's going. Do not just react to the pace that they are setting. 2, do not make them the center of your world. You need to be disciplined to keep activities with your friends and maintain your self-care. 3, avoid the special trap. If you're dealing with a narcissist, they're very good at making you feel like you're the most special person in the world. Then start feeling special that they're choosing you out of all the options that they have to choose from. But they don't know you. Slow it down. Don't outsource your validation to this person you just met. We break up bootcamp for more tips.
Okay, so Coach Michelle Monet, you told me that I was desperate in love. You told me that my picker was broken. How do I not do this anymore? I'm gonna tell you. You're welcome. The first thing you wanna do is, when you go out on a date, when you're hanging out with your boo, just have fun. Stop planning your future in the door. Instead of going in a situation envisioning yourself walking down the aisle, just take it day by day, date by date. Number two, stop romanticizing love and relationships. In society, we have been taught that relationships